Let's just read it. Everybody take your Bible. Let's go to Romans 12. Romans 12. Amen if you're there.
Amen.
Verse 1. And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to God because of all he has done for you. Let them be a living and a holy sacrifice. The kind he will find acceptable. Let's stop right there. Why did God not accept Cain's offering?
It wasn't acceptable.
It wasn't acceptable. It wasn't pleasing to the Lord. Do you give sacrifices to God that are not pleasing to him? See, when we live our life for Christ, if there's not a sacrifice there, you're not living for Christ.
That's why it says leave it at the altar.
Leave it at the altar.
Go and make it right.
See, I think one of the greatest issues that we have in ministry today is there are people serving and leading, but there's no sacrifice there.
Jesus.
When you lead worship, there ought to be a sacrifice there. He's the creator of the world. It shouldn't be a three songs and you're done.
Come on.
I'm not against three songs. I'm not against you sang 12 songs. It doesn't matter. The point is, it's a sacrifice. I've watched too many worship leaders lead worship because they're good singers and they're good musicians and they lead worship and their home life gets absolutely steamrolled because they didn't realize there was a sacrifice to singing to the Lord and leading people. This is truly the way to worship him. Don't conform to the world. The NLT here says, don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
Do you copy the behaviors and customs of the world? Sometimes, I bet we all do, right?
Yeah.
Read Facebook. Just check Facebook out. Type in political and just see where you stand. I'm serious. I'm talking a lot about this because I believe that we're so close to the end of the age.
Absolutely.
That like it matters, right?
Yes.
We're not here. We're not debating. We're not here to tell you who to vote for. We're not here to tell you any of those things. If you're not willing to go look up the issues yourself, look up the policies and procedures that are being brought forth, then whatever. Then you don't care that much. But the point is this: you find out who you are when people close to you disagree with what you say or what you believe.
That's so good.
Wow.
You really find out who you are and what you believe when people that are close to you come against something that you say or something
wow.
you believe.
Come on. Mm.
Right.
I mean, there are families being divided over who they're voting for.
Yeah.
Stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Absolutely.
That's not true. I've heard of stupid things. But I've lost friends because we believe in signs, miracles, and wonders. Why do I believe in signs, miracles, and wonders? Because the Bible says, and?
We see them.
And we've seen, like, hundreds of miracles. Yeah, but those ended. Not here in Nashville.
Come on.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'm sure. He can hear now. There. He can hear, yeah. So I don't know. I mean, you tell me. Coincidence? He couldn't hear before and he just could now? Okay. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world. Do you argue with people that have no significance in your life either? No, baptism at birth is not how it goes. Is that worth arguing over? Because that's what the world does. You wear a black shirt every week, Evan. Really?
Looks good.
Really? Really, yeah. Just in case I sweat, I mean, I just make sure I got my shirt on.
Sometimes you wear the King Jesus one.
I like blue.
All right. Do not conform to the behavior and customs of this world. What about when you talk? What about when somebody cuts you off in traffic? Do you sound like everybody else? But the Bible says, be transformed by the renewing of your mind, by changing the way you think. What does transformation mean? Metamorphosis. Caterpillar becoming a
butterfly. Surrender is the key.
So when you're transformed, look, if this is review for you, it's review. Good. Caterpillar's entire life exists right in front of them. Terrible eyesight, and all they do is eat. Are they able to get anywhere? Not really. They can crawl a little bit, but they're on leaves, right? They don't fly. Leaves. They're on leaves. I don't know.
Way to go, baby.
They just crawl, and all they do is consume everything in front of them. They just consume in front of them. My favorite thing about that is when they're in the cocoon, they hang upside down in the pitch black, and then literally what they used to be melts off of them.
Come on.
See, when your mind is transformed, it's not that you just like make better decisions. It's that you actually take off the old man and put on the new. You actually receive the mind of Christ. So you stop thinking you and you start thinking him. That's transformation. When you're like, I don't know, should I do this or should I not do that? What is God saying? Well, I don't know. Well, if you don't know, you might not have the mind of Christ, because he provides peace that passes understanding, or he removes it, not because he hates you, but he wants you to turn around and get peace. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Say, his will is good.
His will is good.
It is pleasing.
It is pleasing.
And it's perfect.
And it's perfect.
Because of the privilege and authority God has given me, I give each of you this warning. Don't think you are better than you really are.
Come on.
Well. Say, I need.
I need.
No, say, I need.
I need.
To not think.
To not think.
That I'm better.
That I'm better.
Than I really am. Be honest in your evaluation of yourselves. Can we just stop right there? Oh, Lord Jesus. Listen, this is going to sound harsh, but hear my heart.
Oh, boy.
Can't wait.
Some of y'all are the best liars.
We love you.
Some of us are the best liars when it comes to you. I think one of the biggest problems that we have in this body sometimes is we don't evaluate us. We're evaluating everybody else.
Ooh.
But see, when you actually take a serious look at you, it's really hard to look at anybody else.
Come on.
Here we go. Be honest in your evaluation of yourselves, measuring yourselves by the
faith
God has given us.
Faith.
Just as our bodies have many parts and each part has a special function, so it is with Christ's body. We are many parts of one body and we all belong to each other.
Amen.
In his grace, God has given us different gifts for doing certain things well. Listen, if you're in this room and you wish that you had a different talent or a different ability, take that up with God. The point is, he saw it fit for you not to have that. So if God has given you the ability to prophesy, speak out with as much faith as God has given you. If your gift is serving others, serve them well. If you are a teacher, teach well. If your gift is to encourage others, be encouraging. I was just really encouraging to you guys. And I called you guys good liars. If your gift is to encourage others, be encouraging. If it is giving, give generously. If God has given you leadership ability, take the responsibility seriously. Let's stop again.
Jesus.
How many knows we're at the end of the age? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So your relationship with Christ should be the only thing that matters. Mm. Now, once again, don't quit your job. Don't forsake your family. Kids will be fine. It's the end of the age. They're good. No, that's negligent. That's not what we're saying. Are you taking your responsibility in the body of Christ seriously? So I know we have a lot of new people, and that's great. Love that. Praise the Lord. But for those that are here regularly, are you taking your responsibility in this body that God has placed you in seriously? Or are there a lot of things that come in before what God is doing? Because you know we're always going to be here. Dang. This is not about Cheyenne and I. I served at a church for 4 or 5 years. Never missed a Sunday. Was never late. Was never late.
Never.
I was never late.
Wow.
Ooh. I'm not bragging on that. I was very legalistic when it came to that. The point is, are you taking your role in this body seriously? Well, you didn't appoint me a leadership role. Yeah, I didn't. Cheyenne didn't.
So good.
But are you a part of this body? If you're a part of this body, see, we're all part of the body of Christ, right?
Right.
But I'm talking to our people right now. If this is your church, if this is your home, if this is where God has brought you, see, we haven't tried to convince anybody to stay here. Matter of fact, we've convinced people to leave. You're still here. You got enough crazy in you that you're here. You love Jesus enough.
Yeah.
But are you taking your role seriously, Filter? Here we go. And if you have a gift for showing kindness to others, do it gladly. Don't. All right, now we're all going to say this. Say don't.
Don't.
Just.
Pretend.
To love others. Don't.
Just.
Pretend.
To love others.
Really love them.
Really love them.
Hate what is wrong.
Hate what is wrong.
Yes.
Hold tightly to what is good.
Hold tightly to what is good.
Jesus.
Can somebody pull up that post that I post? Posted? Post that I posted? The Paul Washer one. I don't want to butcher it, but it's very important.
Instagram, honey?
I don't know.
He did Facebook.
I think I did both.
I think both.
Maybe
I only saw Facebook.
Will you read there? Say that loud. Your catch.
We okay?
Everybody is
listening. He was about to throw it.
We thought he was about to throw the mic.
Okay. The question is not, do you know you are a sinner? The question is this: has God so worked in your life that the sin you once loved, you now hate?
That is the question. Do you hate the sin in your life? Do you hate it? Because if you don't hate it, then you love it. Prove me wrong. Just kidding. I'm serious though. Prove that statement wrong. If you don't hate it, you love it.
Prove me wrong.
I just hate. I hate that I'm drinking. I just hate that, like, I can't put it down. Does that mean that it's, like, nothing in your life? No, it means you love it. It means the worldly side of you loves it.
That's right.
Yeah, you hate that you love it.
You hate that you love it.
Wow.
Verse 10, love each other with genuine affection.
Love each other.
And take delight in honoring each other. We need to do that. Oh, boy, we need to do that. Okay, let's just say this. Say never.
Never.
Be.
Lazy.
Lazy.
Never.
Never.
Be.
Lazy.
Lazy.
Somebody needs to receive that right now in the mighty name of Jesus. But work hard and serve the Lord enthusiastically. Ooh. Do y'all know what enthusiastically means?
Tell us.
I don't know the definition. Enthusiasm. It means like lots of enthusiasm. Oh, good. Got it.
Received. Good job, Chucky.
Received.
Got that one.
Received.
You're a dictionary.
We did receive it.
Dictionary.
I think you're showing intense and eager enjoyment, interest, or approval.
Yeah, like, say it again.
Having or showing intense and eager enjoyment, interest,
intense.
Or approval.
Showing intense or eager enjoyment.
Ooh. Approval of the gospel. Do you approve of the gospel?
Oh, and the next one's good. Verse 12. Rejoice in our confident hope.
Oh.
Do you have confident hope in your life?
Wow, yes.
Sometimes, right? When the stars are aligned and I'm not being attacked. So much hope. Do you have confident hope when your life is falling apart and all hell is coming after you?
Yes.
You should. Bible says so. Be patient in trouble and keep on praying. When God's people are in need, be ready to help them. When God's people are in need, be ready to help them. When God's people are in need, be ready to help them. Always be eager to practice hospitality. Hospitality does not mean you just opening your doors. Hospitality means actually honoring the people that are coming to your house. I know I don't always do that well. I apologize. Get out.
Get out.
You got 5 minutes to get out.
Out.
Or the lights are off.
Out.
Get out. I apologize. Sometimes there's just stuff you got to do. You know?
I understand.
One of my favorite things is when I'm like, guys, lights off, 5 minutes. I see everybody look at me, and then they look at Cheyenne. And Cheyenne doesn't even stop the conversation. So they're like really torn. I'm like, do I
get off?
Anyway, they just look at Cheyenne, just like, I'm with her.
I do that.
And they honor
I'm sorry, Kevin.
He's got a paper on this.
And I stand in the back like this. I think there's more people when I announce, I'm going to shut everything down.
Everybody gets closer to Cheyenne.
Yeah. She's good. She lives here. Probably runs out of time. He will do whatever she says, I think. I don't know.
That's so good.
He acts really tough until she tells him to do something, and he's off doing that thing. Verse 14. Bless those who persecute you. Bless those who persecute.
Wow.
Do you know that, wow, that right there does not say forgive those who persecute you? It says bless those who persecute you.
Wow.
I believe some of the reason we don't have breakthrough in our life is because we're really good at saying the words, I forgive you. But we're not blessing, and we are not blessing, we are not blessing, nor are we forgiving from our heart posture the people that are persecuting us. We are condemning them with our heart, but with our lips we are saying, I forgive you.
Wow.
Oh, I forgave them. Oh, yeah, you look like it. Bless those who persecute you. Don't curse them. Pray that God will bless them. Why? Why would you pray that somebody that is persecuting you would be blessed? Because they need it, and he's there. They are God's child.
Yes.
I know. Relax. What? Verse 15. Be happy with those who are happy, and weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with each other. Don't be too proud to enjoy the company of ordinary people. And don't think you know it all.
Come on.
Say, I don't know it all.
I don't know at all.
I don't know at all or it all. So have you studied the Hebrew? I'm like, no. Do you know like Greek fluently? No.
No.
Did you go to seminary? Oh, no. I play football. I can barely read. So like you guys like have, so y'all like you have a church? Like, I don't know. People show up all the time and get set free.
Come on, Kevin.
Yeah, but what qualifies you? I'm like, oh, I'm not. So you're not qualified as a lead? Is like, is there a senior, Kevin? Is there an older, like wiser? Nope.
Do people really ask that to you?
Oh, you'd be shocked at some of the questions you get.
And you say,
so
football?
These people just keep showing up and like they're radical for Jesus? Yeah.
I can barely read.
Well, what are you doing?
I barely read.
We read the Bible like a lot. No. I mean, like, what are you doing to get them to come back? We don't. We kick people out. We kick people out? Yeah. We have no growth plan. We have no vision statement. Guess what else is mind-boggling to some people is when they say, well, do you teach on tithing? And I'm like, no, we've tried a lot. We just don't do it. The Lord keeps showing up. Do people tithe? And I'm like, yeah, almost 100% of everybody that comes to this church. But, so like, how do you get them to do that? I'm like, I don't know. We don't even take an offering. I have no idea. We've never passed.
Unless missionaries.
We've never passed
a
bucket.
Taken one.
So you don't take an offering.
It's the Bible.
You don't teach on tithing.
Bible.
And your people give? I'm like, yeah.
It's
amazing.
Like this.
Wow.
Why? Oh, because God told us to. So like you don't even like have to like make them show up? I'm like, I mean on time, yeah, but no. See, there was a time, and I'm sure somebody can identify with this, and when I was in college, I thought, I can't wait to go witness to the whole world when I know more of the Bible.
Wow.
Because I'd be able to answer questions. I got stumped in college, and it threw me for a couple years. If God's so good, why do bad things happen? And I was like, can you phrase that differently? Say that again? And he said it, and I was just like, well, I mean, you know, like, the devil's bad, and, I mean, obviously, I mean, do you know the devil is bad? I don't know. And I remember thinking, if I don't have an answer, I may not be the believer that needs to go share the gospel. I'm just going to have me and God time. Now, when I see, and don't think you know it all, I think, yes, praise God, because I don't. I feel highly unqualified. Highly unqualified to live for Jesus. And yet he called and chose me. And that's all I needed to hear.
Wow.
He set his spirit in me. I didn't need anything else. And I don't think that you need anything else to live for Christ. You don't need validation from Cheyenne or me. You don't need a seminary degree on your wall. I'm not against seminary. If you want to go to seminary, go to seminary, whatever. But you don't need that. All you need to do is have a connection to the source.
Right.
And when Jesus said, "You are mine and I am yours," done deal. That's all I needed to hear. Cheyenne said, "Can people come into our house?" I was like, "Yep." "What are we going to do with them?" She's like, "I don't know." "Okay, let's do that." And some of y'all have never left. Verse 17, never pay back evil with more evil. Do things in such a way that everyone can see you are honorable. Do all you can to live in peace with everyone. I want to stop. Listen, do all you can. That all still means all in that scripture. But does that mean that you compromise what the Bible says to have peace with somebody else?
No.
Okay, good. There's four no's. Seriously. No. Do you compromise what the Bible says to live in peace with somebody else?
No.
But can you keep peace in your own heart?
Yes.
Yeah. I think the church is bending over backwards for people that are living in the world and living for the world. And they're bending over backwards to look like them, sound like them, and feel like them. And they are compromising what the Bible says a follower of Christ is. And I'm begging you, if that's you, please stop. Compromise is the spirit of the end of the age.
Wow.
Once again, going back to politics. There's an entire group of people that believe it's okay to murder a child.
Jesus.
Listen, I'm not even against those people. I'm not against them. It's a spirit of murder. It's a spirit of murder. But instead of actually talking about what life means, the church is silent because they've compromised for so long to look like the world, to get the world to show up in their seats, that now they look and talk and act and believe just like the world. Oh yeah, I'm sold out, follower of Christ. Pro-choice. Wait, what? Explain that to me. See, I don't ever tell anybody they're wrong because who am I? But I will ask a billion questions. Explain that to me. What does the Bible say about that?
Come on.
Well, you tell me what the Bible says. I don't know. The Bible says murderers won't go to heaven, so I'm not really sure. You tell me.
Come on.
You tell me. I don't really know. I'm not God.
Amen.
But I know that both of my boys were moving in her stomach, kicking. One of them was sucking their thumb. You tell me that they weren't alive. Nope. Okay. That's life.
Come on.
Filter. Here we go. Do all that you can to live in peace with everyone. Dear friends, never take revenge. Leave that to the righteous anger of God. For the scriptures say, "I will take revenge. I will pay them back," says the Lord. Instead, if your enemies are hungry, feed them. If they are thirsty, give them something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals of shame on their heads. Don't do it so burning coals will be heaped on their heads. Do it because the word of God tells you to do it. I want to tell you something. One of the greatest examples of a follower of Christ is when somebody comes against you and then you stand firm in your faith, but you continue to love them.
Amen.
Took me years to learn how to do that. When I had family coming after Cheyenne and I saying, "You're wrong, you are wrong, you are wrong, you are wrong," instead of retreating or fighting back, what if I just stood firm and loved them right where they are? That's fine. You don't have to agree with me. I can't convince you, but I love you very much. See, not with my voice or my words, but in action. People in this church know exactly what I'm talking about. When people come against you for reading your Bible, they're not coming against you for drinking or sleeping around. They're coming against you for reading your Bible.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Jesus. You want to know how you're at the end of the age? Is when reading your Bible is wrong.
Wow, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you don't go party, you just read your Bible? Really? That's all you're going to do? I want to read this at the very beginning of chapter 13. Everyone must submit to governing authorities. Yes, you have to pay your taxes. For all authority comes from God, and those in positions of authority have been placed there by God. So anyone who rebels against authority is rebelling against what God has instituted, and they will be punished. Listen, does that mean you bow your knee to the golden statue created because a king or a queen or a president tells you to do so?
No.
No! When people say whatever the president says goes, whatever the king says goes, and I said, well, not at all if it's against the word of God. Amen. And the scripture came up. But I think we have this mindset that we're better than authority. Mm-hmm. And we don't submit ourselves to authority.
Come on.
Police officer pulls you over, pull over.
Amen.
You were speeding. No, I wasn't. You're going to lose 10 out of 10. Yeah, you were. No, I don't think I was. The Bible says. No, you can't.
No.
My pastor said. No, he did not.
Hey,
Kevin, I'm in jail. I told him exactly what you said Friday night, and they arrested me. Can you come bail me out? All you do is this. Hello? Kevin? Hello? He's not there. Nope, I'm not there. No, I'm kidding. I can't get you.
Amen.
Verse 2, so anyone who rebels against authority is rebelling against what God has instituted, and they will be punished. For the authorities do not strike fear in people who are doing right, but in those who are doing wrong. Would you like to live without fear of the authorities? Do what is right, and they will honor you. I want to tell you something in this room. We don't conform to the patterns of this world. You get transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Yes.
And when your mind is renewed, the Spirit of the living God will actually speak to you. You won't have to know if you should go this way, or this way. He will lead and guide you. And if He leads and guides you, and it's against something that is put in writing that somebody wants you to do, you must bow to the golden statue. I'm telling you, if you're not filled and renewed, you will bow. There are going to be millions of quote-unquote Christians one day say, I will never bow. I will never bow. Oh, I'm just going to do it for the good of those that are around me, for my family.
But
I love you, God, secretly.
Oh, Jesus.
If we are ashamed of God here, He will be ashamed of us there.
Oof, Jesus.
Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. How do you get your mind renewed?
With the Word.
Eat the Word. Yes. Digest the Word. Spit it up. Eat it again.
Yes.
Find out what it says. Mm-hmm. I'm amazed at some of the questions that Christians ask. So, murder's wrong? Are you serious right now?
Oh my goodness.
I'm serious. Is abortion wrong? Is homosexuality wrong? Is drinking wrong? Don't ask us. Find out for yourself what it says. If you want to have a conversation after that, let's do that. Listen, it is that important.
Yes.
Is healing for today?
Yes.
Do signs, miracles, and wonders still exist?
Yes.
Yada, yada, whatever. Go down the list. But there are answers to everything in here.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Yes. Yes.
But if you're not living in the Spirit of God, you may not find it.
Mm. Come on. Mm. Wow.
Jesus.
This is only a sword if you give the Holy Spirit permission to cut you and shred you up with it. If not, you fall asleep while you read this. But when you give the Holy Spirit permission and you start eating the Word. Matter of fact, I told Cheyenne yesterday or today. I said, I used to get up early and I'd have these incredible moments with God. I thought they were incredible moments with God. I'd get revelation on something. But guess what would happen? I would feel good about me.
Whoa.
Believe what I'm learning.
Oh
man, I'd write it down so good. God, you are so good for giving that to me. Because my heart was in the wrong place. And I told her, I said, there's just, to me, there's nothing now like reading it and trying to find Him.
Wow. Yes.
For Him.
Yeah.
Amen.
Don't just pretend to love others. And I'm thinking, oh my goodness, He came. He came. He is love. And He came. And everybody hated Him. And they spit on Him. And they whipped Him. And they plucked hair out of His beard. And they they literally killed Him. And He loved them. That's my Jesus. See, that's not revelation. I'm now I'm going to change my life forever. I'm going to love others. It's that the Spirit of God is love. And when the Spirit of God releases into you, you don't have to try to love anybody. Love comes out of you.
Yes.
And then you see people that are hurting and you're out like, I'm going to put my, I'm really going to do this now. I'm going to help them. Mm. It's like you can't help it. Whew, Spirit of God, Spirit of God, Spirit of God.
Mm. Thank you, Jesus.
Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Mm. I believe that's what he's saying tonight.
Yes.
Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Mm. Be transformed. If you're conforming to the world, be transformed instead. Because the world will lead you to hell. And it will make you feel so good doing it. I believe we have access right now to whatever you need. It may not come in what you think you need. It may not show up in your mailbox when you get home. But I believe that we have access to the Creator right now for creative miracles, for baptism of the Holy Spirit, for healing, for breakthrough, and for your mind to be rewired with the mind of Christ. So, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come before you humbly. Your word says that if we humble ourselves under your mighty hand, you will lift us up in due time. And Lord, I believe for this body it is due time. It is due time. It is due time. And Lord, our job is to humble ourselves, not yours. So I humbly ask that you would come and just let your Spirit do what it wants to do. I, as the head of this house, I give free rein to this place. I say, Holy Spirit, do anything you want to do. Come bring conviction. Come bring breakthrough and come bring healing. Lord, please bring renewal to our minds. Let us start right now. Let this be day one. Let this be the beginning of breakthrough. Let this be the first opportunity that somebody who doesn't have ears to hear, that they can hear. That somebody who doesn't have eyes to see, that they can see. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, come and move right now. Mm.